Today we have initiate practice. We haven't done this much since we passed the test to become demon hunters, but we originally joined the church as initiates. We lost our parents 7 years ago. They died in a carriage accident coming back from work.
Cullote, you need to pray too. Like this? Yes. Prier? Where are Mommy and Daddy? Mommy and Daddy, they've gone far, far away. But I know they'll always be watching over us.
I want my daddy! I want my mommy!
Please don't cry, Cullote, okay? It's all right. I'll take care of you from now on, just like Mommy did. Okay? Mother? Father? Please don't worry about us. No matter what happens, no matter how tough things get, I'll do my best. I won't give up. I'll be strong. But please let me be weak today.
We spent the next 3 years in the orphanage, and then joined the Church of the Holy Maiden. I was only 5 when my parents died, so I don't really remember them. Prier never talks about Mom and Dad. Oh, Goddess Poitrine, please let me meet my Mom and Dad just once.
That's enough for today. Everyone practice hard for the service this weekend.
That was great! I just love to sing! No one cares how loud I am. Yep! Oh, I feel like something good is gonna happen today.
Hey, Prier, listen. I had a dream about Mom and Dad last night.
Cullote, what am I gonna do with you? You'll never grow up, will you?
Whenever I start to talk about our parents, Prier always changes the subject. She always treats me like a child. Nothing wrong with having a dream.
Chapter 2, A Child's Promise.
Watch out! Hey! What the?
That should have blown him away.
You still need practice, Prier.
Father?
Oh, he really scared me there. That's Father Salade. He started the Church of the Holy Maiden. And he's our boss, too. He may not look it now, but he's a very distinguished man. And he's defeated hundreds of demons. He was also the one who rescued Alouette 2 years ago. She had completely lost her memory. Sister Alouette became a demon hunter without even taking the test. It's true that she's very skilled, but I kind of think that Father Salade is giving her special treatment. I wonder if he's secretly in love with her. Nah.
What's with the bear suit?
My wife asked me to put on a show at the orphanage.
You gotta be kidding. And you have to play a giant teddy bear?
You never could stand up to the director, Father.
That's the truth. I'd much rather be out fighting demons, but...
No, it looks good on you. You're so cute.
That's enough of that. I'm still your boss, you know. Anyway, you're probably wondering why I asked you all here. I need your help in investigating a certain incident.
An incident?
That's right. You may have heard the rumors. In the last few months, there have been many grisly murders. Sister Olive is currently on the case, but as of yet, we still have no leads on a suspect.
Wait just a minute. Why should the Church of the Holy Maiden be investigating a murder? Why can't the police do it?
Well, why don't you let me finish first? These murders have a certain disgusting... unusual aspect to them. Publicly, they're being treated just like any normal murder. What the public doesn't know is that in every case, the victims' hearts were ripped out.
Their hearts?
That's right. Their hearts ripped out. But the really unusual thing is that in every case, someone else from the family is missing. The royal police are looking for the missing people, but so far they haven't had any luck.
Sounds like an open and shut case to me. The missing family members did it. It's just a matter of arresting them, right?
You'd think so, wouldn't you? But here's where things get interesting. First, in every case, the room was locked from the inside.
A locked room murder.
Second, as I said before, there is someone missing in each family. The missing family members range from young boys to old women. They're all different. Third, there was a message written in blood with a finger at the scene of every crime. Fingerprint analysis shows that the finger belonged to the missing person in the family. Fourth, the message left behind at every murder was exactly the same in every case. And a handwriting analysis shows that they were all written by the same person. What do all of these things tell you?
The prints belong to the missing people, but one person wrote all of the messages. And the missing people disappeared from a locked room. But that's impossible.
Father, you're saying that the culprit is a shape-changing demon?
Precisely! Well done, Sister Alouette. They assume the form of a family member to get close to their target. And then they rip their victim's heart out. It's likely that the real missing family members are dead and buried. What do you think, Prier? Can a normal person do that? Of course not. That's why we've been asked to look into the matter. This is a request directly from the Queen herself. We can't refuse.
This is Sister Olive. There's been another murder. It's in Section 3C-203 of Potifu City, a house on Mirabu Street. I'm currently trailing the suspect. It looks like he's headed for Mount Tart. Request backup.
Roger. I'll send help right away. I want you to go after the suspect immediately. Use extreme caution. Repeat, use extreme caution.
Roger.
Well, what are you waiting for? Get to the scene of the crime and help Sister Olive. In the name of the Maiden of Light, may the goddess Poitrine watch over you all.
In the name of the Maiden of Light, we ask.
Thank you.
My beloved Palmier, why have you gone and left me all alone? But I'm not sad, because I know that you will soon return to me.
Hey, Cullote! What's the matter?
Oh, nothing. I was just thinking of all the memories I have of this place.
Memories?
Yes. Prier and I grew up here on Mount Tart. You might say it's our hometown.
Really? Why did you have to go and bring that up? We don't have time for that kind of nonsense now. Why don't you just shut up and carry the luggage?
I'm not your servant. I'm a demon hunter too. How about a little respect?
What are you talking about? Let's face it. Carrying stuff is the most useful thing you can do.
I'm a demon hunter too. I'll show you. You idiot.
Did he just call me an idiot? Cullote! Where do you think you're going? What'll I do? Cullote ran off by himself!
That's hardly surprising. You were pretty hard on him.
What? But we always talk like that, right? I was just kidding.
It may have been a joke to you, but Cullote was obviously very hurt.
Oh, no.
Cullote is in danger all by himself. Let's go find him.
Bye.
Forgive me. Goddess, forgive me.
Thank you.
goddess, forgive me. Forgive me.
light.
Thank you.
Rest in peace. Forgive me. In the name of the Maiden of Light. Thank you.
You make me sick. The way you change your shape to fool your victims, it makes me sick.
Who are you?
I'm nobody special, but if you really must know. The name's Croy. Croy Raoul. I'm a freelance demon hunter. I'm working for the Church of the Divine Mother at the moment. The boyfriend of one of your victims hired me. Now, be a good little demon and let me kill you.
Wait!
What? You don't know how to give up gracefully, do you?
You said the Church of the Divine Mother, right? I'm one of their members.
Is that right?
Yes. We're practically brothers. Cut me some slack. You can let me off this time, right?
Sorry, no can do.
I see. In that case...
I can tell you're trying to read my past to take the form of someone I loved. I'm on to you. But, unfortunately for you, I have no memory of my past. Now then, it's time for you to say goodbye.
Cullote!
Stop it. You'll never make it to heaven like this.
Don't make me laugh.
I see. In that case, please allow me to help. But I get to keep 70% of the reward. You guys get 30%.
I don't care about any reward! We've got to help Cullote!
I may not look it, but I like to keep things businesslike. We've got to... This is the first time we've met, isn't it?
Yes. So?
No. Never mind. Let's go take care of that demon.
Hoonigrah!
forgive me.
That's it. You've only got yourself to blame.
Forgive me.
Here we go! Ha!
Rest in peace.
Bye.
goddess, forgive me. Forgive me.
Time to go. You've only got yourself to blame.
In the name of the Maiden of Light.
That was close.
of the Maiden of Light. Forgive me.
Yourself to blame.
the Maiden of Light. I ask you, Goddess Poitrine, burn his sins away with the flames of your judgment. Please, at least allow him to rest in peace.
Joking me.
Why did you do that? You can't run off by yourself like that.
I'm sorry I worried you. Guess I should stick to carrying the luggage.
Sister Prier, Cullote wanted you to understand that he's starting to grow up. He wanted you to realize that he can make it on his own. And not always be a burden to you.
Is that true, Cullote?
You always protected me, ever since I was little. But things can't go on like this forever. So I wanted to try something on my own.
Don't be stupid!
Stupid!
I'm your big sister. I'm like a mother to you. You don't have to worry about things like that.
Sorry to intrude, but you don't understand men, do you? As a man, I know what the kid is going through. He wants to show you that he's growing up. He can't be tied to your apron strings forever. To you, he'll always be your little brother. But a man needs to feel independent. Don't you think it's time you realize that?
Prier, I'm a man now. I want to protect you. I want to protect Sister Alouette, too.
I see. And I thought I knew everything there was to know about him. But I was wrong. Cullote's grown into a young man, and I never even realized it. I guess I wanted him to remain a child forever. Maybe I didn't want him to go and leave me. But I guess I was the one who was being childish. Cullote?
Yes?
I'm sorry for what I said.
Kate?
I won't mother you anymore.
Okay.
When we grow up, we'll eventually have to follow our own paths. But for now, I want to stay with you. I want to protect you. Don't you think the goddess would allow that? Yes, I'm sure she would. So?
Yes.
For now, I'm gonna keep bossing you around.
They're quite a pair, aren't they?
They certainly are.
But to tell the truth, I'm a little jealous of them. I don't have any family. Or even a past to call my own.
That night, I saw Prier crying by herself. She must have been thinking of our dead mother and father. Prier always tries to look strong, but sometimes I wonder. Anyway, I think that's why she never wanted to talk about them. She didn't want to look weak in front of me. I didn't know what to say to her. I just...